Good morning, students. I guess you are doing great today. We thank God Almighty for yet another day. I am Mrs. Sufele Chika, agricultural science teacher. I welcome you all to Regina Patchy's online teaching. Today, we are going to look at the topic viral disease of farm animals. But before we proceed as usual, we have to first of all look at the specific objectives. By the end of the lesson, the students are expected to list the viral diseases of farm animals. They are also expected to discuss the viral diseases under foster organism, species of animals affected, symptoms, preventive and control measures. Now, in our previous class, we've defined disease. We've also mentioned the viral diseases of farm animals. We are going to continue from where we stopped from our previous class. Now, the viral diseases of farm animals are: number one, foot and mouth disease; two, rinderpest disease; three, Newcastle disease; then finally, fowl pox disease. Now, in our previous class, we've already talked about foot and mouth. In today's class, we are going to look at rinderpest, Newcastle and fowl pox under these headings. Now, starting with rinderpest, we already know that rinderpest is a disease that is caused by virus in farm animals. So the foster organism for this rinderpest is virus. Now, the species of animals that suffers from this rinderpest are cattle, sheep, and goats. Now, how do they contact this rinderpest disease? They contact it when they come in contact with an already infected animal. Secondly, through direct contact with infected water, food, and bellies. By bellies, we mean litter materials like sawdust or dry grasses that are kept on the floor in the farm animal houses. Now, what are the symptoms of this rinderpest disease? The first one is blood-stained diarrhea. The feces of the farm animal will be watery and mixed with blood. That is blood-stained diarrhea. The second one is grinding of the teeth. The animal will sing, grinding its teeth. The third one is that when the teeth discharge from the mouth, nostrils, and eye of the farm animal will be discharging mucus from its nostrils, mouth, and eye. Then finally, high fever. The high fever is as a result of the pain associated with the disease. Now, symptoms. The preventive measures. The preventive or control measures. Now, how do we control this disease? First of all, is you isolate, burn, or bury the already infected animals. Once you suspect this rinderpest disease in your farm, you have to isolate the animal that have already contacted it from the rest. The second one is quarantine new stock. Quarantine is a word we are very familiar with. Now, quarantine is the process of isolating or separating the newly imported animals in order to test them and certify them disease-free before mixing them up with the ones already in the farm. Then proper sanitation. You have to observe strict hygiene in your farm. Then finally, routine vaccination. You have to be vaccinating these farm animals regularly as at when due. Alright, now we are going to look at Newcastle disease. What is the cause of this for Newcastle disease? It is caused by virus. Now, the mode of transmission for Newcastle disease is the same as when rinderpest we talked about and
foot and mouth disease, they are the same. Now let's look at the symptoms. Symptoms of Newcastle disease. The first one is nervous paralysis, such as twisting of the neck. The next one is coughing, sneezing, and the animal will be seen gasping for breath. That is inability to breathe very well. Now, the preventive or control measures is equally the same as the one we've already talked about, which is you observe proper sanitation in your farm, you quarantine new stock, you vaccinate the animals regularly. Now, finally, let us look at fowl pox disease. Because fowl pox disease is caused by virus. Now, the species of animals affected, these fowl pox affect only poultry. The symptoms is just that yellow eruption is seen on the comb of the poultry. You know what is comb? Comb is that reddish structure that appears on the head of fowl. So yellow eruption, instead of the comb to be red, it will be seen to be yellow this time around. So yellow eruption on the comb of the fowl. That is the only symptom of fowl pox disease. Now, the preventive or control measures is the same as in others. Isolate infected animals, quarantine new stock, practice good sanitation on your farm, and finally, vaccinate the animals regularly. Alright, now having known this, you do this assignment. Number one, you set the two symptoms of Rinderpest disease, two symptoms of Newcastle disease, and finally, one symptom of fowl pox disease. You tear up a sheet of paper as normal, write your name and your class, you write it and forward it to my WhatsApp number.